folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on downloading files from MinIO using our Java client API. And in this video, we're going to be using OpenJDK 19 and Maven 4 for managing all our dependencies. And we're going to be connecting out to play.min.io, our online sandbox where anybody can connect and work with the MinIO platform. And all of our code, we're going to be running this out of Visual Studio Code today. And just to get into a little more detail, we're going to be working with the download object method today. This is a little different from the get object method, which we're going to look at in another video. And we're going to work with the download object args, which is how you set all the variables that you need to actually download an object. So let's go ahead and take a look at some code. And here in our code, we've got our app class with its main method. Our main method, again, is really just doing some simple work. It's going to actually make a connection to play.min.io for me. And then it's going to call this demo method. It also handles all my exceptions so that I can just focus on the code that I want to show you folks. And that code is right here in my demo method. The main piece of code we're going to be running is this download object method here on line 40. This method doesn't really have any return. It doesn't need one because what it's going to do with download object, it's actually going to create a file on my local file system. And if that file exists, then it worked. And if it doesn't exist, then there was a problem. Again, this may throw an exception, which I will handle in the main method if I need to. So what do we hand to the download object method? Well, that's our dargs object. That's our download object args. So how do we work with this dargs object? Well, the dargs object is built from our download object args builder. That's a static method. And what we're going to run against that is our bucket and object. This is our source bucket and our source object up on play.min.io. So I'm grabbing the hello world text object from the Java demo bucket, and those files are already up on play.min.io for me. The file name is going to be the destination file, and I'm going to download it to a file called new.txt, and that's going to be in my temp download directory. So let's go ahead and build this with Maven clean package, and this is going to build an executable jar file for me called demo-1.ojar. And let me show you that right now, if I clear this one more time, if I look right now in my temp download directory, there is nothing in that directory. That directory is empty. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do a java jar target demo, and when I run this, I get my prompt right back, and then if I do that ls temp download again, well, there's my new.txt, and I can do a cat that temp download new.txt, and what do I get? I get a little output from a website called the Bob Ross Lorem Ipsum, and this is just some text that I like to show off. So let your imagination be your guide. It's always good advice. So at this point, that is largely everything. Let me show you what happens if the file, or rather the object, does not exist. So I'm going to change this to an object that is not on the system. I have to do a quick rebuild like so. And once I've got that rebuild done, if I do a java jar target demo, I get an illegal argument. Oh, well, I get an illegal argument because the new text already exists. But if we remove that new text, temp download new text, and run this one more time, we're going to get a different error. And that error is actually that the object that we're trying to get does not exist. So both cases there for you. If the file that you're trying to write to already exists, it will not override it on your local file system. But if the object does not exist, you're going to get an exception. And this is actually a MinIO exception that basically says the object doesn't exist. And that is everything that we have for downloading a file from MinIO. I hope you've enjoyed this little demo. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also work with us interactively on Slack at minio.slack.com, or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you for the next one.